Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's video, which is a question and answer session for some questions that came through on the comment section of my YouTube channel. Now, the first one is regarding the use of ND filters, and in particular the variable ND filter, when shooting video with Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras. Now, the particular question was aimed at the FZ300 330, but it applies to the FZ80, 82, the 300 330, and indeed the FZ1000. With the FZ2000, 2500, we have a different situation there because with the camera has inbuilt ND filtration, which you can use to your advantage. But with the other cameras, you don't have ND, and you've got to apply secondary ND filtration to the lens to reduce the amount of light going into the camera. So why do we need to reduce the amount of light reaching our camera sensor? Well, it's all to do with what's referred to as the cinematic look, and it's a way of recreating how film looked when it was projected through a projector onto your screen. As film was normally shot at 24 frames per second and they use what's called a 180 degree shutter rule, they would be using a shutter speed of about a 48th or a 50th of a second to create amount of subject motion in blur, which the eye perceives as normal. When we shoot video, in particular with our bridge cameras in bright sunshine, the camera might choose a shutter speed which is up to about a 1,000th of a second or even a 2,000th of a second, and this gives our video quite a bright shaky look rather than the natural perceived motion we get with a slower shutter speed. So if we can actually reduce the amount of light so we can get a longer shutter speed, then our videos will look much nicer. Now, I have to say, I was trying to shoot this outdoors today, but it's sunny intervals here in the UK, and I've not been able to get a long enough sunny spell to be able to demonstrate what I need before the lighting changed and destroyed the effect that I was trying to show you. So I've come indoors and recreated a basic scene that I can show you the changes to ISO, shutter speed and aperture, and how these will affect the way that the video looks when we change the amount of light coming into the camera by the application of our ND filtration. So, first of all, let's have a look at the shot that I've got set up here on the FZ8082. I've got a scene set up, and you can see my current shutter speed is 1/400 of the second with an aperture of f3.3. My ISO is 100, and I'm currently shooting in the manual creative video mode. If you also look on screen, I've got a histogram here which is showing the distribution of tones as seen by the sensor and the normal population. We're going from highlights on the right to shadows on the left. So, if we look at this video, and I'll start the camera recording. With a shutter speed of 1/400 of a second, it isn't going to be too bad. It's not too far away from the 180 degree shutter rule. It's nowhere near the 1,000th of a second or 2,000th of a second, as films like Private Ryan were shot, and you can see the blood and water spray and individual droplets as the fast shutter speed is freezing the motion. So with a 400th of a second, our looks are similar to what we would achieve with a longer shutter speed, i.e. twice a frame rate. So in this particular shot now, have a look at the way the arms and legs are moving in this particular video. The amount of subject motion and blur is very, very low, so the effects look quite staccato. I'm going to increase the ISO to 3200, which means I can actually increase the shutter speed. So first of all, let me increase the ISO. So I've gone to ISO 3200, and to get the exposure right now, I can change my shutter speed, so I need to go faster. And again, watching the histogram to make sure we keep the highlights in control. So there we've got about a 1300th of a second. So if you're looking at the amount of subject motion blur now, this should be very little at all. So it is very staccato, the effect that you're seeing on the video. Obviously, there's going to be a little increase in noise because we've increased the ISO. I kept the aperture the same, so the amount of depth of field stays the same. So the reason we're reducing the shutter speed is to create a natural amount of subject motion blur. So I'm going to use the ISO first of all, and I'm going to reduce that to a sensible value so we're not going to see too much noise. So I'm going to bring the ISO back to about 1000. So with the ISO back to 1000, my shutter speed is 1/1300th, so I'm going to reduce the shutter speed until my histogram is normal and it changes back to white. So there, the camera thinks that's the correct exposure, so 1/400th of a second again. So let's put the shutter speed down to what should be twice the frame rate, and that will give us the true lit cinematic look. In doing so, we'll overexpose. So let me now change that shutter speed to 1/50th of a second. So I'm shooting at 1/50th of a second because my current frame rate is 25 frames per second in full HD. So if I want to keep the same depth of field, then I'll leave the aperture alone and I will use the variable ND filter that I've got over the lens. Now this is an ND filter which goes from ND2 to ND400. So I can attenuate the light from about 1 to 5 or 6 stops. So I'm going to turn the ND from its minimum value and I'm going to increase it until we get the histogram back to the way it looked with the faster shutter speed. So I'm now starting to turn the filter to increase the amount of neutral density being applied to the lens. Bring back the histogram so we can see it. You can see the scene is starting to get a little bit darker. Histogram's moving over to the left. Increasing the ND. And that's roughly where the original histogram was there. So we've now got a 50th of a second, same aperture, the same ISO, but we've attenuated the amount of light to the sensor. And you can see there's an element of subject motion blur in those moving arms and legs, which is more natural to the way we see film being projected in the cinema. So that is why we've reduced our shutter speed to 1/50th of a second. Now you might say, I don't shoot in the manual mode. And the reason you don't shoot in the manual mode is because if your lighting changes the way it was today, then you've got no control over your exposure. If you're in one of the semi-automatic modes, so P or A or S, then the camera will automatically change the component that's still variable. So if you're in shutter priority, your camera will change the aperture to maintain the exposure. Or if you're in aperture priority, the camera will change the shutter speed. But we want to try and keep the shutter speed the same, so you'd probably shoot in shutter priority mode. So I'm going to change the camera now, its setup, into shutter priority. And if I go into the video record screen and I go to exposure mode, I'll go to shutter priority. Come back to the main shooting screen. So in the shutter priority mode, you can see that the shutter speed that we've got set is 1/50th. Our ISO is 1000. And if you notice the histogram, the camera has changed the exposure to give us the correct exposure. And it's done that by changing the aperture. And it would have changed it to that f3.3 value that we had previous. If I now change the ISO to ISO 500, so we need to let more light into the camera. You can see now that the scene has gone darker. And now we can't change our aperture less than 3.3 because that's the minimum aperture we've got with the amount of zoom on the camera. So to get the exposure right again, we need to reduce the amount of attenuation being applied by that neutral density filter so that the camera will receive more light. So if I turn this now towards the minimum, you'll see that the histogram is moving over to the right. And there we are, we've got the normal exposure again. So that's the way that you would balance your exposure using variable neutral density on the front of your camera lens. Now, there are some situations where if you're shooting in the fully manual mode, the minimum shutter speed you can apply is 1/25th of a second if you're shooting in a PAL mode, or 1/30th of a second if you're shooting in NTSC mode. But if you set up for manual exposure and manual focus, you can actually change the shutter speed to down to 1/2 second. So if you're in nighttime shooting and there's no subject motion, or say cars moving or people moving, you can use those long exposure shutter beads to get you better nighttime video. So let me show you the effect of changing those shutter speeds. So first of all, we need to go back into the exposure mode and change that to manual. And we need to change the focus mode into manual focus, as that enables us to change the shutter speed. So I'm going to go down first of all to parity with the frame rate. So I'm going to go down to 1/25th of a second. So that would normally be the minimum shutter speed, and to balance that I'm going to change the aperture . There we are, our histogram has turned white again, so the camera thinks this is the correct exposure. So our exposure is f5.6, so we're getting slightly more depth of field. Now if I go back to changing the shutter speed by just pressing the back control dial on the FZ8082, if I change the shutter speed now to a half of that, so if we go down to a 1/13th of a second, you can see the exposure meter showing that we're one stop overexposed. Now change back to the aperture, we can go from 5.6 up to 8. See the exposure is balanced again, and again we've got more depth of field. But if you notice the amount of subject motion blur we've got with a 1/13th of a second, it's much more pronounced. So if you wanted to do light trails or something like that, then this is the way you would do that with your camera. You would set manual focus in the manual creative mode, and you can change the shutter speed. So just for laughs, let's go down to 1/4 of a second. So to balance the exposure now, I can't change my aperture more than f8. I could actually reduce my ISO, so let me reduce the ISO. Need to go a little bit more to balance the equation. We are 160 ISO to give us the right exposure. So if you look now at the amount of subject motion blur, it's more pronounced. So let me record some video first of all at 1/4 of a second. So this is video being shot with the FZ8082 with a shutter speed of 1/4 of a second. And then we'll change the shutter speed again to 1/25th, and again we can change the aperture. That's our maximum we can achieve with this amount of blur. So the only other option we've got is to reduce the amount of attenuation on the front of the lens, if we have any, by reducing that some more. And there, so we got 1/25th of a second. Let's record some video. So now we are recording video at 1/25th of a second and 25 frames per second. And for the final scene, we'll do 1/50th of a second to see the actual effect of the twice frame rate shutter rule. So we'll change the shutter speed to 1/50th. And again, we can reduce the amount of ND filtration to there. So now we've got the right exposure, we'll record that. So that is the correct cinematic look of the video when we shoot at twice the frame rate for our shutter speed. Well, I hope that answered the question for the subscriber that wanted to know how to control the amount of light and how to get the right exposure using variable ND filter with Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras. So until my next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.